Hello friends, you are watching ERUDIRE Plus, the professional CAD-CAM solution provider. Let's get started.
Hello viewers, this is the third video of this coursework, and through this video I'm going to show finite element analysis of a simply supported beam carrying a lot of lumped masses at a specific distance away from left hand side. Right, let us see the statement of the problem. A shaft of 40 mm diameter and 2.5 mm long has a mass of 15 kg per meter. It is simply supported at the ends and carries three masses of 90 kg, 140 kg and 60 kg at a distance of 0.8 meter, 1.5 meter respectively from the lift support. Taking modulus of elasticity as 200 GPa, find the frequency of the transverse vibrations. This is the problem. So it is very clear that we are having a beam of diameter 40 mm and length 2.5 mm and it is carrying lumped masses at a different distance away from the left hand side, and the lumped masses are having mass of 90 kg, 140 kg and 60 kg located at a distance of 0.8 meter, 1.5 meter and also 2 meter from left hand side. Our task will be to find out the natural frequency of the transverse vibration. By the same time, we will validate our results through theoretical calculations, and we have to analyze this one using ANSYS mechanical APDL, right? So without wasting time, let us start our analysis using ANSYS mechanical APDL. First of all, we need to create a directory, and that can be done using file, change directory, and we can save it at any specific location as per our requirement, right? We're not saving, but we can save it, right? Next to that, we need to provide some specific naming to this file. That can be done from file and change title. We can provide name of this one as FEA3. As this is the third video of this coursework, so we are naming this one as FEA3. Okay, to see the title, we can click on plot replot. So the title is visible at the lower left corner. As per normal rules, we need to start from preferences. It is showing what type of analysis it is. It may be structural, thermal, or different types of. It is a structural analysis, right? Next to that, we need to select elemental properties, and that will be started from preprocessor. Element type, add, edit, delete. As nothing is defined, so we need to add it. We're considering beam with three defined strain. In this case, we're having three different lumped masses and also one shaft. So we need to consider four different types of masses. The first one, beam with three defined strain, is considered for the shaft, and for lumped masses we'll be considering different things like structural masses, right? First one, we are considering beam, three defined strain for the shaft, apply. Next one, we need to select structural mass for the different lumped masses, apply. Second one is also done. Third one, apply, and finally the last one. Okay, so we have selected three different lumped masses and also the shaft. Let us see the properties of all these things from options. First one, type 1 with beam 188 element, and element behavior, it will be cubic form. Okay, next one, type 2, and it is mass 21. From options, it will be 2D rotational. Third one, again, it will be same type. It will be 2D. And finally, the last one also, same type. It will be 2D. Close it. Next to that, you need to provide real constants. Actually, real constants are required to provide the masses for the specific location, for the lumped masses only. So, let us add, edit, delete. Nothing is defined, so we need to add it. First one is mass 21, type 2. For this one, we need to provide a mass of 90 kg. Okay, done. Then the second one, for type 3, we need to provide the mass of this one as 140 kg. And you can see that real constant set is actually 2 for this one. Okay, done. Then the last one, so real constant number 3, and for that mass will be 60 kg. we have provided three different lumped masses having masses of 90 kg, 140 kg and 60 kg. Okay, close it. Next to that, you need to provide material properties, material models, structural, linear, elastic and isotropic. Isotropic means material property remains same in all directions. And modulus of elasticity is 2 into 10 to the power 11 Newton per meter square. That is 2E11. And Poisson's ratio is 0.3. And we are providing density as 718.00 kg per meter cube. Okay, done. Next to that, we need to provide sections. And this is a circular cross-section shaft. So we can select the beam properties, beam, common sections, and from subtype we can select circular one. And our shaft is having diameter of 40 millimeter, so radius of this one will be 20 millimeter. That can be converted to meter as 0.02 meter. Okay, done. Next to that, we need to start modeling. For this modeling, we can remember that the shaft was having total length of 2.5 meter and from the left hand side at a distance of 0.8 meter, we provided the first lumped mass. At a distance of 1.5 meter, we provided the second mass. And at a distance of 2 meter, we provided the third lumped mass. So we need to create 5 different nodes. So create nodes in active coordinate system. First node will be created at the origin. By default, it will take the origin value, so apply. Second node will be created at a distance of 0.8 meter. Apply. Third node will be created at a distance of 1.5 meter. Fourth node will be created at a distance of 2 meter. And finally, the last node will be created at a distance of 2.5 meter. Okay, so we have created 5 different nodes. Now all these nodes will be connected in the form of elements. So elements, auto numbered through nodes, select node number 1 and 2, apply. This is the first element. Select node number 2 and 3, apply. This is the second element. Select node number 3 and 4, apply. This is the third element. And finally, select node number 4 and 5. Okay, this is the fourth element. We're having 4 elements, right? Now we need to provide lumped masses at specific locations, and that to be done from elemental attributes. Beam 188 is the shaft, so this one to be changed. This is second one, and real constant set for this one will be 1. Okay, auto numbered through nodes, select node number 2. Okay, so at node number 2 we have provided the lumped mass of 90 kg. Next one, again we need to change the elemental attributes. It will be the third one, that is 3 mass 21, and also real constant set number, it will be different, it will be 2. Okay, auto numbered through nodes, let us select node number 3. Okay, done. So at node number 3 we have provided lumped mass of 140 kg. And the last one, again we need to go back to element attributes. We need to select the fourth one, and from real constants we need to select the third set. Done. Okay, and auto numbered through nodes, we need to select the fourth node. Done. So we have provided lumped mass at defined locations at node 2, 3 and 4 from the left hand side at a specific distance away. Next one, we need to start our solution. Solution analysis type, new analysis. It is a modal analysis and we need to see analysis options. By default, it is having block language options. We are having a lot of options, and in this case we are considering PCG language, and numbers of modes to extract equal to 1. At the same time, it will be numbers of modes to expand equal to also 1. done. Next one, we can select the default setup. It is ready. Next one, we need to apply our boundary conditions. So define loads, apply structural displacement on nodes. As it is a simply supported beam, so we need to apply our boundary conditions in a proper way, right? Let us select node number 1. Okay, it will be UX, UY, UZ and rotation X and rotation Y. Okay, next one, for the last node, select node number 5. Okay, and here we need to select UY, UZ and rotation X and rotation Y. And the displacement of this one is 0. That means we are having restricted motion at node number 1 and node number 5. Okay, done. This is simply supported beam. Everything is done. Now we can run it. So solve current LS. Okay. Now it is showing solution is done. We can see our results from general post-processing. So general post-processing, first of all, we see result summary. It is showing results equal to 2.96. We can save this result, as this is a very important one. We can save it. We can remember this one back to be compared with the theoretical solution. So we need to compare this one also. Frequency is equal to 2.96 hertz, right? Let us close it. We can see the mode shapes also. So read results, first set, plot results, and deform shape. We want to see deform plus undeformed. Okay, you can see this is the mode shape. As this is one of the results, so we can save it. So plot controls and capture image, and file can be saved at a specific location. We can save it, right? Done. Now we can do one thing. We can have the animation of this beam, so that can be started from here. Plot controls, animate, mode shape, and with the default setup, let us see the animation. And we can view the animation in a better way by reducing the delay period. See how this beam will be vibrating under the lumped mass. This is a simply supported beam, and at three different locations from the left hand side, we have provided three different masses as lumped masses, right? Let us close it. This is a 2D one. We can see this one in the form of 3D also. For viewing this one in 3D, let us see plot controls and style, size and shape, and display of elements should be on. Okay, right? So this is the beam. We can see circular cross sectional beam, right? Fine. Now another thing can be done, that is, we can see the listing results also. You can see the results in the form of numbers, that is nodal solution, D of solution, and we want to see displacement in Y direction, Y component of displacement. These are the results, and you can see maximum displacement is occurring at node number 3. It is minus 0.64 into 10 to the minus 1, right? We can save this result also. File save as, with a specific name, we can save it. Let us close it. You can see these lumped masses also. At different locations, we have provided these lumped masses. Alright. So, we got our results from ANSYS. Now, this result will be validated using theoretical calculations. Okay. So, let us close it. And we need to go back to theoretical calculations. So this was the problem. This is a simply supported beam of total length 2.5 meter, and from left hand side, at a specific distance, we have provided different lumped masses, right? Lumped masses of 90 kg, 140 kg and 60 kg. So our task will be to validate these results. We have already done finite element analysis using ANSYS mechanical APDL, and that result to be validated using theoretical calculations. Let us go back to the next slide. See, this is the beam, simply supported beam, this one, right? Now the thing is, in this case, what happens is, first of all, we know that our task is to find out frequency, right? The actual relation of frequency is equal to Fn equal to 1 by twice pi square root of g divided by deltas, right? We are having different deltas, delta 1, delta 2, etc., right? Delta is deflection. Now, 1 upon twice pi, no? So, what can be done is, square root of g divided by twice pi is equal to 0.4985, this one. So, square root of this one, we can put it in the left-hand side. Square root of g divided by twice pi is equal to 0.4985, and delta is equal to, under root, we are having deltas, delta 1, this is delta 2, and this is delta 3 for different lambda masses, and this is the delta for the shaft. How to calculate delta? For calculating delta, we need to depend on different parameters, like you can see delta equal to mg square b square divided by 3 e il, right? And here m equal to mass, g equal to acceleration due to gravity, a equal to distance of that lambda mass from left hand side, and b equal to distance of that lambda mass from the right hand side. Distance a and b will be varying for different lambda masses, right? We are putting all these values and see that delta 1 equal to 0.0866 meter for the first lambda mass, and for the second one we can find delta equal to 0.169. So in this case a is different, a equal to 1.5, and b equal to again 1, because total distance equal to 2.5. and for the third lambda mass we can find delta 3 equal to 0.20312 meter. These are the things, but for the shaft we need to find something else. For the shaft, the formula is a little bit different. For the shaft, delta is equal to 5 mgl to the power 4 divided by 384 EI. By applying all these things, we can find out the deflection of the shaft, that is equal to 0.00298 meter. And applying all these things in the final equation, we can find frequency equal to 2.85 hertz, right? And for ANSYS also, we got the value 2.96 approximately. 2.96 hertz, right? So the difference is very less. So percentage, you can see in this case it is very less, it is approximately 3.8% something else. So our analysis is validated with the theoretical calculations, right? This is all about our third video, and in this video we have find out the frequency of the transverse vibrations, and also we validated these finite element results with the theoretical calculations. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. And if you have any kind of doubts, please write to me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye.